गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, मैं ऑडिबल एंड विजिबल टू ऑल ऑफ यू। गुड मॉर्निंग वाहिनी, गुड मॉर्निंग श्रेया, गुड मॉर्निंग स्वाति, हाउ आर यू? संतोष, गुड मॉर्निंग। तेजस्वी, हाउ आर यू बेटा? आई होप एवरीवन इज फिट एंड फाइन, एज आई ऑलवेज से। गुड मॉर्निंग हैनक, आई होप यू आर डूइंग वेल। ओके, सो वी बिगिन टुडेज लेक्चर विद द सेम ओल्ड इंस्ट्रक्शन। गुड मॉर्निंग तेजा, कार्तिक, कोंडा, यशवंत, गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर फिट एंड फाइन। I am doing fine, Karthik. Thanks for asking. Okay, let us start today's class with the same old instructions that I always give you. Sit in a place where you get good network. First, keep your cameras off. Second, so that you don't use data. Third, and most important, if you have to send any message, you can send it on my ask ID of Astik or to everyone. So everyone sees your doubt and we can all rectify them as required. Now, coming back to what we were discussing in the last class, we were doing some amazing things, very good things with the chapter of relative motion. I had given a problem for you to solve. Good morning, Guru Jogeshwar. I had given you a problem to solve. And I think many of you, for 5, 6, 7 of you, had done it. I had done it correctly regarding the overtaking of the two cars. I am still disappointed that not all of you tried the question, but still, well, begin is half done. So I hope and I assume that from now onwards, more of you would take active participation and do the homework. Anyways, I also asked you to try question number 7 from your book. From your notes, have you tried that? I think someone tried it and gave me an answer as well. Someone tried it and gave an answer as well. I think this was the question that I was referring to. Example number 7 from your notes. I hope you are aware of this question. Who solved this question? Karthik, yes, Karthik. Sorry, see, I have short-term memory loss, Peter. Just forget things. I remember that someone has sent me the message and I also replied back to you, Karthik, and I told you that whatever you have done is absolutely correct. There is no doubts about it, what you have done. I was asking you, could this be done in a different way? That is what my question was. And that is what my question is right now. Karthik had solved it. Very nicely done. Karthik, can you unmute yourself? Let me give you a chance. Where is Karthik? Karthik, can you unmute yourself and tell me what you had done? How did you solve that question? Karthik, can you unmute yourself and tell me how did you solve it?
Yes, sir.
Yes, beta, tell me.
Sir, first I found the distance traveled by A with respect to ground.
Correction here. Karthik, did you find out the distance traveled by A or did you find out the displacement of A?
Displacement traveled by A with respect to ground.
Okay. Again, one simple correction. Displacement is not traveled. Displacement of A with respect to ground. So what is Karthik saying is that he found out the displacement of A with respect to ground. That was the first step. Right, Karthik? Am I correct? Karthik, did I lose you? Karthik is gone. So what I'll do is, I will allow you, all participants, to unmute yourself on your own so that I don't have to do it again. I lose a lot of time. Karthik, can you unmute yourself now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, tell me, Kartik. What next? What was the next step that you did? First, you found out the displacement. Then you found out the displacement of
B separately.
B separately with respect to ground. Very B. good. Yes, see.
And subtracted, sir, for the separation.
Okay, got it. I think your network is not very proper, so your voice is breaking in between. I hope my voice is better. Let me again explain what Kartik did. Kartik found out the displacement of A with respect to ground. Case number one. Yes, now you can hear me. Then Kartik found out the displacement of B with respect to ground. And then he subtracted the two displacements. And that is how he got the answer to this question. Absolutely correct. And this is how, if you see in the solution, this is how this question is solved. The first case is the displacement of A with respect to ground. That is what it is solved. And the answer is zero. That means it comes back to its original position. That is case number one. Case number two, they have found out the displacement of B with respect to ground.
Raule.
In second case, they found out the displacement of B with respect to ground. Done that, Karthik. Don't worry. In second case, they have found out, who is this gentleman? Was he saying something bad? Karthik? It was not in the language that I understand. Was it something rude, bad? Shall I remove this gentleman, whosoever it is? Okay. So he goes away. For always. Okay, I hope we don't get disturbed. Okay, but I don't understand the language. I could not understand what he was saying, but I knew that it is not good, obviously. So he's been thrown out of the room. Don't worry. Okay, so where was I? I was discussing how the question was done by Kartik and how the question is done in the book itself, in the note itself. We find out the displacement of A with respect to ground. Then we found out the displacement of B with respect to ground, and then they subtracted and got the answer as 5 meters. Absolutely correct. Nothing wrong in it. But as I said, could this be done in a different way? That was my question to Kartik. Kartik, have you thought about it? When I say Kartik, I mean all the others. Have you thought how this could have been done in a different way? Slightly different way. Anyone? Yes, sir, but no idea. We think in horizontal. I don't know, Hanak, what you are talking about. The motion is vertical. How will you solve it in horizontal? There is no motion along the horizontal. Remember, the name of the topic that we are doing is definitely relative motion. Right. How to do this in a different way? Anyone? I will try to solve this question by using displacement of A with respect to B. That is what I will try to find out. Displacement of A with respect to B. Now let us see what is the advantage of doing so. Now to find out the displacement of A with respect to B, first I have to find out the initial velocity of A with respect to B. Initial velocity of A with respect to B. How will I find out the initial velocity of A with respect to B? Anyone? Anyone? Kartik? Anak? Anyone? Teja, Anil, Likit, Maruti, Venu, Anjali, Arpit, Harsh? How will I find the initial velocity of A with respect to B? Yes, beta. Velocity of A with respect to ground minus velocity of B with respect to ground. Do we understand this? Do we remember this? Vaini says, yes, sir. Great, Teja. Teja also remembers it. Can I have raise hand that we understand this, sir? It's nothing complicated here. It's simple, plain application of what we have done. I only have 9 reasons, 10 reasons. That is not good enough for a class of 50 students. So let me start. Rajesh, Jyoti, Manasa, Tarun, Vijay, Tarun, Harshita, Surendra, Siddharth, Shivthamika, Sana, Sai, Rakesh, Sanjay, Ganesh, Dinesh, Jogeshwar, Sainath, Yashwant, Kartik, Kevin, Jayashankar, Goli, Jagdish, Satvika, Saitarun, Harsh, Anjali, are we all there? Are we all there? Are you understanding this? Yes. So, now I put the values. What is the initial velocity of A with respect to ground? It is given here upwards. So, it is plus 5. What is the initial velocity of B with respect to ground? It is given here. It is upwards, minus, plus 10. Do we all understand this? Do we all understand this? Yes, sir. So the answer is minus 5 meter per second. I have got one answer. I have got one u, initial velocity of A with respect to B. Let us now find the acceleration of A with respect to B. Acceleration of A will be acceleration of A with respect to ground minus acceleration of B with respect to ground. Now both are 10. This is minus 10. This is also minus 10 because both are equal to G. So your answer becomes 0. Acceleration of A with respect to B becomes 0. Do we understand this? Do we understand this? Can I have some raise hand that you understand this? It is absolutely clear, sir. No problems. What about time? How much is the time given to us? Fine. The separation between them after 1 second. Time is given at 1 second. Yes or no? Yes or no? Please tell me yes or no. I know the initial velocity. I know the acceleration. I know the time. I have to find out the displacement. Which equation should I use? Anyone? Yes, Anak has come up with an answer without me even asking the question correctly. Second equation. Displacement of A with respect to B will be equal to initial velocity of A with respect to B, which is minus 5. So minus 5 multiplied by time, which is 1, plus acceleration is 0, so plus 0. And my final displacement is minus 5 meters. That means with respect to A, B is downwards. Am I clear? A with respect to B, displacement of A minus displacement of B. So when you are looking from B, A is 5 meters downwards. Am I clear? They're talking about separation. They're talking about the distance between the two, which is the magnitude of displacement. So the distance between the two become 5 meters, and that is the answer that they were looking for. Can I have some reason that we have understood this? I lower all your hands. Now the thing starts. How many of you have understood this question? I have 3, 4. Let me have more reason that I have understood this question, sir. The way Kartik solved it was absolutely brilliant. It was absolutely flawless. But again, he had to use minus half gt square once, minus half gt square twice. In my way, in my method, I've just shortened it a bit. That doesn't mean that I am more intelligent than Karthik or he is less intelligent. No. It only means that I have applied the concept that I have understood in a better way. Am I clear? What about the others? Have you understood this? Rajesh, Jyoti, Manasa, Tarun Garikapati, Harshita, Siddharth, Sai Sarda, Rashwant, Rakesh, Rahul, Sanjay, Ganesh, Dinesh, Jogeshwar, Karthik, Sashank, Kevin, Jayashankar, Jagdish, Goli, Goli, where are you? Satvika, Charita, Saitarun. I hope everyone is there in the class. Anjali, Maruti, Harsh, Liket, Anil, 9/Rajesh/A. Nice name. Do you all understand this? Great. They're talking about the distance. They're not saying plus or minus. They are saying the separation. Separation is distance. It is not displacement, so I can't call it plus or minus. Got it? That's why the answer is plus. Five. Okay. Now, before we finish this part, I just want to get rid of this one. So what I'll do is, since we are on this node, we will do this part first, and then I'll move on to some very interesting questions. And this part is pretty damn simple. Velocity of approach or the velocity of separation. You might be amused. What is this velocity of separation or the velocity of approach? Let me just make it bigger so that I can show you on the entire screen available to me. Yes. Velocity of separation or velocity of approach. Now, what do you mean by this velocity of separation or velocity of approach? Now, let me. They have explained it in their own language. Their language would be simple or complicated. I'll try to make you understand in my language. Let us suppose that I have two bodies, body A and body B. Let us now assume that they are moving in a straight line towards each other. Body A is moving like this. Body B is moving like this. Now, in this case, what is happening, I find the velocity of A with respect to B or velocity of B with respect to A. If you remember, my dear students, we had seen one very good relation between velocity of A with respect to B and velocity of B with respect to A. Does anyone remember what that great relation was? Velocity of A with respect to B and velocity of B with respect to A. How were they related? Velocity of A with respect to B was nothing but minus of velocity of B with respect to A. Do we recollect this? Vector-wise, they were opposites, right? Now, let us come back to the problem that we were handling. Both of them are moving towards each other. I find the velocity of A with respect to B, or I find the velocity of B with respect to A. They are just different in direction. Now, in this case, what is happening when they are moving towards each other is the distance between them. Listen to my words carefully. Is the distance between them decreasing or is it increasing? The distance between them, is it decreasing? Ready, Yashwan? Or is it increasing? Yes, it is definitely decreasing. They are getting closer to each other. They are getting closer to each other. Distance is decreasing. Whether I find the velocity of A with respect to B or velocity of B with respect to A, doesn't matter. Their distance is decreasing. In this case, when the distance between the bodies is decreasing, and now I'm going to mark it, if the separation between the bodies is decreasing, and we find the velocity of A with respect to B, or we find the velocity of B with respect to A, that velocity is known as velocity of approach. Am I making myself clear? Why approach? Because they are approaching each other. The distance is getting smaller. Am I clear with this concept of the velocity of approach? Whenever distance between two bodies is getting less and less, the distance or separation is decreasing, The relative velocity of A with respect to B or B with respect to A is known as velocity of approach. Can I have some reason that we understand this? We have written this. If you have not written this, it's already there with you in your notes. You can write it while you are writing your notes, looking at the class. You can do it afterwards. The rest I will definitely send. Only 3 people have understood this. Only 2 people have understood this. Velocity of approach. I'll again repeat. If the distance or the separation between 2 bodies is decreasing, their relative velocity of A with respect to B or B with respect to A, I can call it as velocity of approach. Likit, Maruti, Venu, Anjali, have you understood this? Harsh, Shreya, Saitarun, Sumant, Satvika, Jagdish, Jayashankar, Kevin, Kartik, Yashwant, Saina, Jogeshwar, Dinesh, Ganesh, Sanjay, Rahul, Rakesh, Sai, Sana, Siddharth, Surendra, Harshita, Tarun, Venkatesh, Vijay, Manasa, Rajesh, are we all there? Do we understand? Okay, great. Let me take one more example. Here, this gentleman is A, moving with a velocity of 10 meter per second. On the same line lies my gentleman B, moving with a velocity of 5 meter per second. In first case, you will say, what was the first case? This being the first case, and the second case, you'll say, what is the second case, sir? This being the second case. In first case, it was very obvious that whenever 2 bodies are moving towards each other, mark my words, towards each other, their separation will definitely decrease. And in all the cases, it would be velocity of approach. But they are moving along the same straight line in the same direction. In this case, the piche wali gaadi, the person who is back, who is at the back, is having more velocity than the person who is moving in front. In case number 2, is the distance or the separation between them increasing or decreasing? It is also decreasing. So this also would be known as velocity of approach. Am I making myself clear? This also, case number 2, case number 1, case number 2, both are cases of velocity of approach. Am I clear? But I have some reason that we understand this, sir. No problem. It's absolutely clear. Absolutely clear. No doubts. Now, let us all lower our hands. One question, and I would ask this. And if you know the answer, raise your hands. I'll give you a chance to speak. Case number 3. Case number 3. And this is the good color. Case number 3. Ting, 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 ting. Ting, ting, ting. This gentleman is B. This gentleman is A. Now this B, obviously with respect to ground, is moving with a velocity of 5 meter per second. But the velocity of B has become 10 meter per second. And this is case number 3. Now, first listen to my question and then you raise hands and then I'll give you a chance to speak. What is happening in case number 3? Is the separation or the distance between the bodies increasing or decreasing? Hanak says distance is decreasing. Yes, in this case, the separation or the distance is decreasing. Santosh also says decreasing. Well done. What about the others? Does anyone feel that it is increasing? Does anyone feel that it is increasing? Hanak now changes his point of view and he says it is increasing now. What about the others? I don't understand what Reddy has said. Reddy says approach increasing. I don't know. Approach increasing. What does it mean? Separation. or distance between them is increasing. Case three, distance or separation between them is increasing. If the distance between something is increasing or two bodies is increasing, they are getting separated. They are getting separated. And in this case, the velocity of A with respect to B or the velocity of B with respect to A, the separation is increasing, and therefore it is known as velocity of separation, which is the case in case number 3. So I find the velocity of A with respect to B, or I find the velocity of B with respect to A, it will be known as velocity of separation. Am I clear? Do we have an understanding of what I wanted to say? Velocity of approach and velocity of separation. If the separation between two bodies is decreasing, I call it velocity of approach. If the separation is decreasing, velocity of approach. If the separation is increasing, it is known as velocity of separation, because these are getting separated. Can I have a raise of hands from all of you who have understood this question? Only 4 people? Not good. Rajesh, Shashank, Jyoti, Manasa, Venu, Rishika, Vijay, Venkatesh, Tejasvi, Tarun, Harshita, Suren, Siddharth, Sana, Sai, Yashwant, Sanjay, Ganesh, Dinesh, Jogeshwar, Punda, Yashwant, Kartik, Kevin, Jagdish, Satvika, Suman, Charit, Sai Tarun, Harsh, Anjali, Maruti, Viraju Beta. I hope you are there in the class, participating in the discussion. Only 14 people have understood this. I will again repeat it. If the separation between two bodies is decreasing, they are approaching each other, in that case, the velocity is known as velocity of approach. If the separation between them is increasing, they are getting separated, and we call it velocity of separation. Why I have told you this? Because there might be a question that comes to you. There might be a question that comes to you where they don't ask you directly what is the relative velocity. They might ask you indirectly. As I always told you, in exam, the questions that you find are not direct. They're always asked in a roundabout manner. And that is the case with this question. I think that is question number 5 or 6. A particle A is moving with a speed of 10 meters per second towards right. Another particle B is moving with a speed of 12 meters per second towards left. Find their velocity of approach. That is the question I am looking for answers. Let us see who gives me the answer. A is moving with a speed of 10 meters per second. B is moving towards left with a speed of 12 meters per second. What is their velocity of approach? Anyone who has done this, please raise your hands and tell me the answer. I'll give you a chance to speak. Let's see who is the first one. No one? Until now? Could do this? Santosh has raised hand. So Santosh, unmute yourself and tell me how you have done this.
Velocity of A equals to plus 10 meters right side.
Plus 10 meters or plus 10 meter per second?
Meter per second.
Okay. That is A with respect to what? A with respect to ground. See the entire thing, Santosh. See, I have a very small brain. If you don't tell me the right thing, I will get confused. Okay. Let's start again.
Velocity of A with respect to ground equals to plus 10 meter per second.
Correct.
velocity of B with respect to ground equals to minus 12 meter per second.
Why it is minus 12? Why are you using plus and minus, Santosh?
If right side we will use plus sign, it is a vector. Left side we should use minus.
Very good, Santosh. Go ahead.
Velocity of A with respect to B equals to velocity of A with respect to ground minus velocity of B with respect to ground.
Very good. So you put the velocities. Yes. Keep on going.
Velocity of A with respect to ground equals to 10 minus minus of 12.
You should say plus 10. You only told me, na, that you should always talk about direction, isn't it? You said plus 10. 10. Okay. Okay.
Plus 10 minus minus of 12.
So the answer comes as
22 meter per second.
Plus 22 meter per second. Santosh, do not miss the plus sign, because this plus sign indicates the
direction.
Direction. So the relative velocity of A with respect to B is coming as plus 22.
Meter per second.
And what about the separation? Is it increasing or is it decreasing?
Decreasing.
Therefore, we will call it as
velocity of
approach.
Approach.
And the value of velocity of approach is
22 meter per second.
Well done, Santosh. Well done. What about the others? Have you understood what Santosh was trying to tell us? Santosh, you can now mute yourself. Do you all understand what Santosh was trying to tell us? The velocity of A with respect to ground was plus 10, plus indicating the direction forward. Velocity of B with respect to ground was minus 12, minus indicating leftwards or backwards, according to sign convention. Velocity of A with respect to B is velocity of A with respect to ground minus velocity of B with respect to ground. You put the values, you get the answer as plus 22. The distance is decreasing. Therefore, it becomes velocity of approach, and the value of velocity of approach is 22 meter per second. How many of you has understood this? The separation, the distance between them, why is decreasing? They are moving towards each other. They are moving towards each other. The distance is decreasing. The separation or distance is decreasing. When the distance decreases, they approach each other. They are approaching. Approach means coming closer. Separation means going forward, going away from each other. When boyfriend and girlfriend, they break up, they separate, they go away. That is how you understand separation. Separation means away. Opposite of separation is approach. How many of you have understood this? Can I have raised hands? Can I have raised hands? Only 6 participants have understood this. Not very good. Santosh explained it in a very nice way. Sashank, Jyoti, Sai Tarun, Manasa, Venu, Vijay, your friend has done a very good job. At least you must understand this. Triveni, Tarun, Harshita, Sana, Siddharth, Sai Sarda, Rakesh, Rahul, Sanjay, Ganesh, Dinesh, Yashwant, Kevin, Jayashankar, Satvika, Suman, Sai Tarun, Anjali, are you all there? Likita, Anil, Rishika. Okay, that is good. Well done, Karthik. Well done, Santosh. You have explained things very nicely. Now, I am going to ask all of you to lower your hands again as we move on. Jayashankar, okay. Move on to the next question. Someone will solve it and help all of us in solving it again. As I said, learning is a team sport. It's a team game, and here comes the next one in line. A particle A is moving with a speed of 12 meter per second towards right. All of us can see this. Let me use a good pen. I like red. I don't know why. Red and blue. With a speed of 20 meters per second towards right. Another particle B is moving with a speed of 5 meters per second towards right. Find their velocity of approach. Your time starts now. Let me see who gets an answer. Cheta, I have 2 raised hands, so I'll just see who raised hand first. Teja and Deepak, I'll give the chance to Teja. Teja raised his hand first, so Teja gets a chance. Teja, tell me how to do it.
Velocity of A with respect to ground is equals to plus 20 meter per second, sir.
That is correct. Plus means forward. Great.
Velocity of B with respect to ground is plus 5 meters per second.
Great. Plus means forward. Good.
Velocity of A with respect to B is equals to velocity of A with respect to ground minus velocity of B with respect to ground.
That is correct. Well done.
Plus 20 minus of plus 5 gives 15 meters per second.
Mm-hmm. Plus 15. Don't forget the sign of plus. Okay. Hence, now tell me. Is it velocity of approach or is it velocity of separation? And why is it so?
Velocity of approach, sir, because it is decreasing.
What is decreasing?
Velocity.
Not velocity. What is decreasing? Could anyone help? Teja, Deepak, can you help Teja in telling him why is it velocity of approach, Deepak?
Distance is decreasing.
Distance or the separation between them is decreasing. This gentleman is faster. This gentleman is slower. So this gentleman is going to catch up with the gentleman running ahead. The distance is decreasing. Yes, Deepak. And therefore, this is not the velocity of separation, but this is the velocity of approach. Am I clear, Teja?
Clear, sir.
Okay, that is great. So that is what I call teamwork. Doing question in pairs, partners, partnership. You might be watching cricket. When you're watching cricket, the batsmen, they bat in partnerships, test matches. Last day, Pujara and Rahane did it. They fell eventually, but they had a partnership. Partnership is what we are looking at. Partnership in studies can be a partnership between two of your friends or three or five or ten. The more, the better. The more, the merrier. But if it becomes too much, you will just talk and not study. So keep it 3, 4, 5. That is 5, maximum 5. Study in partners. Make friends that you can go home to and, you know, also chat and enjoy, but study. 3 hours of study with partners, good study is more than enough for you to get through. Now, let me all ask you to lower your hands, and then we have understood this question. Deepak and Teja have made us understand this question. How many of you have understood this? Please raise your hands. Great. Only 7. 2 people have done such a good job, and only 7 have understood this. Not good. Saidash, Shashank, Jyoti, Saitarun, Mansa, Venu, Triveni, Tarun, Harshita, Siddharth, Kunde, Rahul, Sanjay, Ganesh, Dinesh, Kartik, Kevin, Sumant, Saitarun, Harsh, Anjali, Maruti, Anil, Rishika. See, I have 22 raised hands now. So the partnership has worked. In the previous question, you are solved by Santosh. We only had 25 in the partnership. Santosh only solved it, and we only had 15 or 18 raised hands. Now we have 25. That means partnership works. You see, simple example. Okay. I hope we are all clear with this. Anyone has any doubts on this? Please raise hands now. So I am going to lower all your hands. Anyone who has a doubt in what we have studied should raise his hand now. Else we are moving ahead with life. We have to move ahead with life. We just cannot stay this way. We have to move ahead in life. Okay. There are no raised hands. That means that we can move forward, and I'll probably discuss one last thing that I wanted to discuss in this particular topic, motion in one dimension. We have discussed almost all types of problems. One type of problem still remains, and that might puzzle a lot of students how to do them. Let us see this. And let us enjoy the beauty of physics. This is a tar. Let us say let us say, let me calculate it first. Let us say this is 5 meters. Let us say this is 5 meters. Let me do one thing here. I'm going to throw one ball from here, ball number A, from point A, ball A. I throw this upwards with a velocity of plus 20. I hope you all understand what does plus means. Plus means upwards. At the same time, from point B, which is the top of this tower, I drop another ball. When I drop another ball, its initial velocity is zero. We all understand this? You all understand this? A ball is thrown up from A with velocity 20 meter per second. At the same time, a ball is dropped from B at a height of 5 meters. Obviously, they are moving in the same straight line. What will happen? This is just like two cars coming towards each other. They will meet. When and where they meet? When and where do they meet? That is the question. As I always tell you, questions and answers are not important. Eventually, you will land up with an answer. And eventually, that answer would be correct if you do it correctly. What matters is what you think, how this question has to be done. Now, I am not saying that there is only one way of doing it. There are numerous ways of doing it. You are looking for the smartest way of doing it. Because my students have to be smart. Smart in the sense that they will find out the easiest and the quickest way of doing it. Vaini has suggested a way. Vaini, would you like to elaborate on what you have said? Let me, where are you, Vaini? Okay. Yes, Vaini, tell me. Unmute yourself, tell me what you are saying.
Sir?
Yes, beta.
Sir, first we should calculate A.
What do you mean by A? What do you mean by A, Vaini? Distance traveled by A? That is what you are looking at? I think we have lost Vaini. Anyone else? See, again, remember, no thought is stupid. No thought is foolish. Your thoughts actually make a lot of sense. Because they help us, me particularly. Hanuk has come up with some exciting way. Hanuk, I'll unmute you. Okay, what I'll do is, I'll allow you to unmute yourself so that I don't have to do it again and again. Okay, I have allowed participants to unmute themselves. So now you can unmute. Hanuk, tell me what you are saying.
Sir, in this question we have velocity of object A with respect to ground and velocity of object B with respect to ground.
See, can I go slowly na? My brain, I told you, a Pentium blast of beginning generation, I am very slow. Tell me what you are saying. We know velocity of A with respect to ground. Tell me how much that is.
Plus 20 meter per second.
Plus 20 meter per second. We all agree on this. What else? This is the initial velocity, right? Initial velocity. I don't know the final. Okay. What else?
And velocity of object B with respect to ground.
How much is that?
Zero.
That is initial velocity of B with respect to ground. What do you suggest, Sanak? What should I do now?
We should find velocity of object A with respect to B.
Okay, let me find out the velocity of object A with respect to B. Hanak is doing exceedingly good. How do I find it, Hanak?
Velocity of A with respect to ground minus?
Initial velocity of A with respect to ground minus?
Velocity of object B with respect to ground.
Okay, now I put the values. What are the values?
Plus 20. Minus zero.
So my answer is plus 20. Well done, Hanak. You have done exceedingly well. Now what should I do? What next? Anyone would like to help Hanak? Hanak is in trouble. Probably. Hanak? Meter per second. Yes, Deepak. I'll just add meter per second. Hanak, do you know what to do next?
Thinking, sir.
Thinking. Okay. Remember that question of cars. Finding T. Yashwan, would you like to help? You can unmute yourself if you would like to help here. We are in a fix. Yashwan, did I lose you? Remember that question of buses and taxis and cars. Cars were trying to overtake each other. We had done that question. This is similar. The only thing is cars are moving up and down. These are like elevators moving up and down. Anyone would like to elaborate? What should I do next?
Sir, we should.
Sorry, Hanak, I muted you. Tell me. Unmute yourself and tell me.
We should find time, sir.
How do you propose that I do it? Yes, I have to find when. So I have to find T. How do you think that I can find T? That is what my intention is. When is T?
Time is same for both.
Time is same for both. So let me call time as T. Okay. How do I get the value of this T? Nice thought. You are good. You are exactly on the same track. Anyone would like to give Hanak a hint or would like to help Hanak? Please raise hands. See, studying is about teamwork. By using displacement formula, I'm getting some suggestions here. Let me see who should I ask. Teja would be the partner. Oops, what is happening here? Yeah. Teja would be the partner here. Where is Teja? Yes, Teja. Teja, unmute yourself. Tell me what we are doing.
Delta R A with respect to B is equals to 5, sir. 5 meters. Plus 5 meters.
Delta R. Very smart. Displacement of A with respect to B. Wow. Displacement of AC. Hanak, you are finding velocity of A with respect to B. That means you are finding everything with respect to B. So B does not go anywhere now. B becomes us. We become B. We become the B ball. Ball B does not go anywhere. Now what do I see now? Ball B does not go anywhere. It is ball A which is going to come and meet it. Now, ball B is not going anywhere. So, how much the ball A has to move? Ball A has to move from ground till the top of the building. Yes or no? Do you understand this?
Yes, sir.
Yes, Hanak. That was missing in your thing. So, you see, Teja has helped you. What is the displacement of A with respect to B? B is not going anywhere. So, that is plus 5. Great. So now I have the knowledge of displacement of A with respect to B, but still I'm missing things. I know initial velocity, I know displacement, I know time. What about? One more thing is left. Who can tell me what is that thing that is left?
Acceleration, zero.
Acceleration.
Yes, acceleration of A with respect to B, Santosh. And how much is that? Both are having same acceleration, yes or no? You throw it up or throw it down, doesn't matter. What is the acceleration of both of the bodies?
minus 10 meter per
minus
second.
Minus 10, minus 10. So it will become zero. Yes or no? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Well done, everyone. Now, you know initial velocity. You have to calculate time. You know the displacement. You know the acceleration. Can you now tell me which equation you can use? Santosh has already come up with an answer. 4 seconds. Which equation should I use, Santosh? Unmute
delta
yourself.
A with respect to B equals to?
Is equal to?
U. A with respect to B into T.
Yes, Yogeshwar, you are also correct.
Plus half AT square. A.
With respect to B, T square. What about this? This is zero. So we know this, we know this. What is this?
5 plus 5.
Plus 5. Well done. What about this?
Plus 20, sir.
Plus 20.
Into T.
Into T. So what is the value of T?
Plus 4 meters.
It is not plus 4. Stupid mistakes are going to cost you a lot. It is 1 four. By 4.
1 by 4.
Someone was telling me plus 4 many times. Who was he? I hope you understand what was wrong, Deepak. What was wrong, Santosh? Stupid mistake. And you must
1/4.
1/4. You must not repeat this stupid mistake. 5/20 is not 4. It is 1/4. Am I clear? So, what we have done? Step by step, step number one, we found out the initial velocity of A with respect to ground, B with respect to ground, step number two. Step number three, we found out the initial velocity of A with respect to B. We have done it many times. We got that velocity as plus 20. Now, we are solving this. B does not go anywhere. B remains at rest. Remember that bus wala question. We are not going anywhere. We are the center of universe. Everything else is coming towards us. B does not go anywhere. So when will A meet B? Same question. Same question here. This was your car. Car number one. This was your car number two. We sat on car number B. And the distance between them was the displacement between the two relative displacement. Yes or no? Same thing is happening. We have become B. We don't go anywhere. A comes up 5 meters plus 5 because it's coming up. That is the displacement. So we get the value of displacement. That is step number 4. We know the value of acceleration of A with respect to B. Both are minus 10. That is step number 5. We assume that time is T. That is step number 6. We put the equation of displacement. That is step number 7. We get the value of time as 1/4 seconds. Am I clear? Can I have some reason that we have come up till this point? Only 6. 3 or 4 of you have done the question right in front of your eyes. You. Let me wake everyone up. Vijay Lakshmi Tarnaka, Shashank Reddy, Jyoti, she never talks. Manasa, Rishi, Vijay, Triveni, Tarun, Swati, Siddharth, Sai, Rakesh, Rahul, Sanjay Ganesh, Dinesh, Gorish, Yogeshwar, Kartik, Shashank, Kevin, Jaya Shankar, Satvika, Charita, Harsh, Anjali, Maruti, Anil, great. But that is only one part of the problem. We have only found out when they meet. One part remains. Who will solve that last part for me? I'm lowering all hands. Who will tell me where? Please raise hands. Where did we meet? Jagdish has raised his hands. Jagdish has lowered his hand as quickly. Anyways, where do they meet? How will you get this? How will you get the answer for where do they meet? Where do they meet? Where do they meet? Ball A meet ball B after 1/4 seconds. Does any one of you recollect what to do next? Where will they meet? This question is now same as the question where does the bus B or bus A overtakes bus B? Bus A overtakes bus B in 1/4 second. Where does it? Kartik has unmuted himself, so I think Kartik has an answer. Kartik, how do I find it out? Satvika, Kartik.
Delta R of A with respect to ground is equal to?
Delta R of A with respect to ground is equal to?
U of A with respect to ground into time.
U of A with respect to ground into time
is equal to
you are not writing the full equation, beta. Don't rush. Plus
half into A of A with respect
ground
acceleration of A with respect to ground
into t square. Okay, now let us put the values. What is the initial velocity of A with respect to ground?
Plus 20 meter per second.
Plus 20. How much is the time?
1/4 seconds.
1/4 plus half. How much is the acceleration?
Minus 10.
Minus 10. Into how much is the time? 1/4 squared is 1/16. Solve this now. So this goes plus 5, plus 5. This is minus 5, minus 5/16 meters. 16 fives are 80, I think. 80 minus 5 is 75/16 meters. So a displacement of A with respect to ground is 75 plus 75/16. Plus means what? Everything has a value, everything has a meaning. It was here. Plus mean it will go upwards. How much will it go upwards, Santosh? How much will it go upwards? Plus 75/16 meters. So it meets at this point C, which is 75/16 meters upwards from the ground. Do you all understand this? Can I have raised hand that you understood this, sir? No problems with this one. No problems with this one. I'll give you one last question for you to solve. I will not dictate it. I will just draw the diagram. Similar question, but now I throw it upwards. So now I throw the ball from the bottom with a velocity of plus 20. From the top with a velocity of plus 5, when and where do they meet? Am I clear? Is the question clear to everyone? Someone asked me something. Hanak, sir, if the velocity is 0, is there a movement of object? Yes, it will move down with respect to ground. Initial velocity is 0, but not acceleration. Am I clear with the question, everyone? Hanak? Okay, so I will wind up this class now with this point. Try this question as homework and put your solutions in the group. I will be looking forward to seeing your solutions from now. This is a wrap from my end. I'll end this class here. I hope you stay safe, stay fine, stay happy. I'll send you this PDF. The other thing is the notes, which is already there with you. So I hope you can see them from there. Bye-bye for now.